welcome back from that whole conspiracy up against Manchester United. Away from sports, we're definitely still talking to the beautiful duo that give us a very interesting performance earlier on. They'll be telling us more about themselves and, of course, the kind of dance that they're actually into. Good morning to you once again, Val and Imi.
Good morning.
How are you guys feeling?
Good.
Great.
Did you get enough time to, you know, grab some oxygen and feel fresh again?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Thank you.
Fantastic.
Thank you for having us here.
It's a pleasure. I like talking to the dancers, but now let's take it back to the root cause. Where did all this start from? How did you guys get to meet and decide that let's actually do dancing?
Well, I wouldn't want to talk much, but it all started with him. Mm-hmm. I had a performance. I think it was still Valentine's Day.
Yes.
I knew. Yes, we have a problem. We never keep those memories.
It was Valentine's Day at Pink Hotel. Mm-hmm. I had a performance with another dancer, mm-hmm. where he also had a performance, but we were different. We weren't together yet. And then he saw me dancing. He's like, "Yeah, that girl." That's what he told me after the performance. Like, "Oh my God, I like the way you dance, and I see your spirit, how you perform. You know, we could just make a great duo." Mm-hmm. So time passed by and we didn't meet. We didn't talk for a while.
Yeah.
Until just 4 months ago.
Last year, around November.
Yeah.
Yes.
When we decided to get together and become a duo.
Yeah, but
you had a partner that you were dancing with on that particular day. Mm-hmm. Hadn't you ever thought about having a duo with that partner years before you actually had that thought cross your mind?
Well, the partner that I had danced with that day, it was just for that day.
Oh,
yeah. He was requested to dance, so he came to me. He's like, "Oh, I have a performance. Can you join me?" Mm-hmm. It wasn't serious. It wasn't. But when I met him, it was serious. It was like how you meet someone in a relationship.
Talk about the magic you told me about.
Well,
you guys are feeling some magic.
There is a connection. Dancing, it requires a lot of connection. The same, you guys should have an ambition together. You have to have a connection if it's not a relationship. So I have a connection with him. I love the way he dances. He's
we're gonna get into more details regarding that connection. But first and foremost, Val, when you saw Imi dancing on stage, and I don't know, just like any dancer, you probably were swept off your feet, but I don't know why. What was the first thing that you saw in her that you really wanted to make this connection? The kind of thing it is now.
What I saw in her was stardom. You know, like she shined out there. Mm-hmm. You know, she took every moment. Like she gave her best. Yes, you know, there is a way we really connect. You know how to speak. You like communicate. You know that?
Okay.
So I really felt like she was dancing from the heart, you know? Mm-hmm. Yeah, whoever great artist you are, but when you bring everything from the heart, even though you're singing, you're dancing, but if it is from the heart, it is true, authentic, you know? That's what she brought out there on that stage, and I really felt it. I was like, ooh!
Four months, you guys doing this thing together.
Uh-huh.
Let us talk about the first weeks you guys had started dancing together. Mm-hmm. How was it like? How did you guys feel towards each other?
Well, to kick off, we had a gig coming up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It was a great gig. We had a wedding. It was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And so we were busy. We didn't have time to process the getting together.
Mm-hmm.
We just get into the studio. We were perfect in the studio, creating all these moves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The way we communicate, "Oh no, we should do this, do that." Mm-hmm. The way we work together is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
That even out there, everyone is like, "Yeah, you guys, how long have you been dancing?"
Mm-hmm.
When we tell them it's like only 4 months, they're like, "Oh my God, you guys look like you've been together for a long time."
And some think we are dating.
On stage,
Now let's get the connection. Let's get the dating, connection, strong emotions. I see you, our hearts beat at the same time.
Mm.
You probably have the
don't
same
you know me that
What is going on between the two of you? Is it more than dancing? Are you guys a couple? Are you thinking about, you know, being a couple? What's going on?
Actually, we're not a couple.
Yeah, we're not a couple. We're both in different relationships.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
She's in a relationship, I'm in a relationship. Yes.
How do you handle that?
Well, it's about trust. When you have a relationship besides this dance relationship that we have, our partners, my partner, I will talk for my partner, because we have a strong relationship, built on trust.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So he believes in me, he wants me to, you know, pursue my dream, and this is my dream.
Yeah.
So any partner would support you, mm-hmm. if this is your dream. And if he trusts you, you trust him, there is no way, you know, if your partner gives you 100... to be honest,
knowing that Valentine's is around the corner.
Yeah, to be honest, yesterday when I realized that we had we were confirmed for this show, I reached out to my boyfriend. I had never asked him what he thinks about this girl, but then when I reached out to him, I asked him, "What do you think? Have you ever felt jealous when I dance with him, or do you feel uneasy?" He's like, "Of course. The way you dance, it's uneasy, but it makes me feel uneasy, but I trust you, and this is your dream, I will support you."
Yeah.
And that's why I say it's about trusting.
Yeah, my girlfriend.
Yeah, keep her right there.
Yeah. My girlfriend cheers me on every show, like everything
she's
I do.
She's
she's not, because she's in her country and back here. Yeah, but she'll be here.
Well, from the court. Is he also in the country? Or is he also out of the country?
He's out of the country.
Woo! All right, I smell it.
Her girlfriend is coming soon.
Yeah, she's coming next month. So the thing is, every performance I do, she's like, you know, I trust you. I support you. Go get it, you know, every like dance, because she knows dance, like everywhere in the house. I'm talking about dance, I'm talking about this and that and that. So really she respects that, and I love the fact, darling, whatever they knew, eh?
Let's think about how this has been in terms of, you know, doing it on a professional level. How has it been for the both of you so far, and the challenges, any downs, and what has been your highest moment on the other hand?
Well, first of all, the challenge I always had to, I got in the beginning, was to really get someone who speaks my language, like someone who feels what I feel, who has the vision, you know. Even though right now, back then, because right now we make money, so even though back then we weren't making money, but they see the vision. Yeah, and it took me quite a long time. I met so many amazing dancers, but then they had other visions, they had other the plans and whatever. But when I met her, you know, to come out.
How about you? How has it been in terms of, you know, achievements, and maybe let's begin it off with the biggest challenge that it has been so far?
Yeah, I have big ambitions, and in this country of ours, it takes a lot of struggle and effort
really
to get to where you want to be. And we when we met each other, I think it made it easier, because usually you cannot perform or do this dance alone. You need someone. It's a couple dance. So when you don't have someone who feels, like he said, who feels the same way about how you feel about dance, like what we have is not a relationship. People ask him, are you guys in a relationship? We just look at each other like, I can never love him.
Okay. Why? I mean, yes, I need to know it. Say it live on air.
The challenges are there. People don't know this dance. And thank you so much for inviting us here, because at least we're putting word out there. This dance is beautiful, it's unique, but people don't know it. So it makes our job hard, makes our career a bit
overshadowed. But now,
we see some salsa involved there and a couple of others, you know.
Yeah, so the full package is Latin and ballroom. Yes, it has very many genres, salsa, cha-cha, rumba, tango. Then when you go to the ballroom, it has the walls and whatever. Yeah.
And so, you know this.
Yeah.
Yes, we do.
Mm-hmm. How often do you practice in a week?
We have 5 hours a day.
Every day, yeah. You have to practice for 5 hours. Mm-hmm. Do you ever get injuries? Do you ever get hurt?
Yes.
Yeah, of course. We do.
Has that happened when you do have a big performance ahead of you?
Yes.
And how did you handle that situation?
Well, when it happens, you gotta find quick solutions, and you have to adjust on the dance moves if you have. That's what happens. You adjust a little bit where you feel comfortable, and you push, because it's all about pushing.
But then she insists too much. You know, there's that move she really loves, and you feel like, you know what, you're injured or whatever, let's do something else. No, That's my highlight. That's my highlight of the show.
That's
one
thing you like about it.
Yeah.
On a professional bit, and like you did mention earlier, you actually earning something from this professional dancing.
Yeah.
Let's talk about the biggest highlight so far. What is that one main highlight that you guys hold very dear?
Recently, we were performing for DFC together.
DFC.
Okay. As a couple, yeah. It was a very great event, and what made it great was the comments after.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when we were going there to have our dinner, whoa, everyone was rushing in, Indians, Americans, Ugandans. Whoa, that's amazing. You're like, wow.
It feels so
yes.
good.
And another thing.
Yes.
Yeah, and another thing still. Normally when you from the stage and you really feel like, yes, we made it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we did it.
How does someone get in touch with you? Probably the viewers watching and they want to learn one or two things about this dance, or they can find a connection, I don't know, somehow, something like that.
Mm. Well, apparently we were really so much concentrating on us, because we really have a big vision and whatever. So we are a bit limited on the teaching, on the lessons. Yeah, but you can follow us on our social media handles.
Yeah,
Kabenga Richard Valentin on Facebook and Instagram. I'm RichVal7.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm soon up getting to Twitter. Yeah, I heard it's expensive.
You have no, it's just like any other apps. Just like Facebook.
Right.
How about you?
Yeah, for me, it's all the way Imi Naraxi.
Facebook, Instagram,
yes.
Twitter as well. Or you also still?
I'm on Twitter, but not very active.
So he's actually affecting you.
He's affecting me. You should join me.
All right. So what would be your last words to the viewers before we get into another big question that I would have for you?
Okay. What I'd like to say to our viewers is that those who have supported us, thank you so much for always inviting us, always allowing us to, you know, perform at your events. And for those who haven't, I'm still waiting on you to invite us, because we want to, we're out there in the studio 5 hours every day to bring out the best, to give you the best at your wedding, at your company event. So we storytell, so anything, let us know, and please always invite us. We're always ready.
How about you? Me, I would really love to thank everyone that has been part of this journey, you know, from back then when I started, you know, it has not been easy. So we are here, Imi and Val, and we have a lot together. And if you're out there and you have a lot of money, man, this is a brand. Come on,
so
come and invest. Yes, they come and invest.
And we have a manager. Yes, she's right there behind us.
What's her name?
She's called Javi.
Javi,
yeah.
She sounds American. Is she American?
she's American because she's a boss lady. She's a really good manager. Oh, yes.
What are you guys planning for Valentine's? It's just a couple of hours from now. What are you guys going to do with each other?
By the way, it's my birthday.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Unlucky job. When are you guys planning on doing for tomorrow?
So tomorrow we have different shows. Yeah, around. Different shows around, and that's what we'll be doing. Personally, I'm expecting you to come out and surprise me, because it's my birthday after the show. Thank you so much. My friends are there, yes. maybe for her, she will surprise me when she comes, next month.
Imi, I will definitely give you
No, but the best,
the way we relate is really, it's like brotherhood, you know, that kind of relationship. I'm there for him, he's there for me, you know, we support each other besides
and
the dancing.
And we add you too much.
The couple that I use. But thank you very much for coming through to our studio. Now, for those of you who have been watching this, and you definitely want to have this beautiful duo dancing at any event that you do have, get in touch with us, Radio and Urban Television as well. And of course, you can get in touch with them personally on their social media handles. And then you would have a beautiful evening that, of course, you would actually leave to remember. Urban Today comes to an end. And we'll see you guys tomorrow for yet another beautiful episode of TBT. We'll be talking about love, Valentine's. So you definitely have to keep it right here with us. And remember, Harvest Month is just around the corner, so keep that 10,000 Ugandan shillings for an amazing time and knowledge at Namboli National Stadium. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Derek Anidasha has been my name, and I sign out. Peace.